In some news just coming in, Jammu and Kashmir Governor N.N. Vohra has rejected Chief Minister Omar Abdullah's resignation. Remember, Omar Abdullah had resigned after the PDP alleged in the Jammu and Kashmir Assembly that he was involved in the 2005 sex scandal. It was right after that that Omar Abdullah had gone to the governor's residence and submitted his resignation letter. But news coming in right now, Jammu and Kashmir Governor N.N. Vohra has officially rejected Omar Abdullah's resignation. Those pictures came in a day before yesterday when there was uproar in the Jammu and Kashmir Assembly after a PDP leader alleged that Omar Abdullah figured in the list of the accused in the Jammu and Kashmir sex scandal of year 2005, which of course brought about an angry reaction from the Chief Minister himself. Tariq is with us on the phone line. Tariq, Omar Abdullah's resignation being rejected by the governor, this is on expected lines? Well, Tariq, if you can hear me, it was expected that N.N. Vohra would reject Omar Abdullah's resignation.
Well, it is now clear that the governor, N.N. Vohra, has rejected his resignation, and is one of the top officials there at the Raj Bhavan said that the governor had said that he had no basis, in fact, to seek the resignation from the chief minister's post. Of course, day before yesterday, after that allegation against him by the former deputy chief minister, Muzaffar Hussain Beg, who literally accused him of being on the list of those suspects who were involved in the Srinagar sex scandal, Omar Abdullah had got up and said that he was driving straight to the governor's house to tender his resignation. Of course, he drove straight to his residence, met with senior party leaders and other colleagues in his council of ministers, who did prevail on him not to take any hasty decisions, that to think through this drastic step that he was intending to do. Of course, there was a lot of confabulation, and only after 2 hours that he had confabulated with his senior colleagues, he drove to the governor's residence, where he said that governor should investigate on a time-bound basis the allegations that were leveled against him by the former deputy chief minister. And of course, governor later in the day had issued a statement where he said that he had asked Omar Abdullah to continue to discharge his responsibilities until the governor himself could clarify and get the statements from the assembly secretariat about what really had been said. And he had at the same time said that till the time he would make up his final mind, he has asked the chief minister to continue to discharge his responsibilities. Now that he seemed to have convinced himself that of that, he has now rejected his resignation, and that, I guess, puts that matter to an end. Umar is likely now, of course, to resume his duties again. And of course, he was there. He had been asked by the governor to continue to discharge his responsibilities.
All right, so Omar Abdullah to continue in the post of Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister. Thanks very much, Tariq, for joining us with those latest details.